Hi everyone! As you can see, I have a new video here on my channel, and the first part was mostly ASMR, but this next part is going to be a voiceover, so let me introduce myself. My name is Zyra, and I post mainly art and drawing videos, so if you'd like to watch more, be sure to check out my channel and subscribe. Today's video is all about doing an unboxing, review, and demonstration of the Zen Art Supplies Fine Art Miniature Brushes. And you've made it past the unboxing, so now let's talk about these brushes. Let's get started. First of all, I want to thank Zen Art Supplies, and more specifically Fabrian, for sending these brushes to me so I can try them out. This set consists of 12 Japanese synthetic paint brushes, all with different sizes and tips, which are great for fine details in your artwork. Each brush can be used for acrylic, oil, watercolor, gouache, and ink, so it's incredibly versatile. And the complete set, including the cute foldable canvas case, is only $35.95 US on their website. Now, I absolutely love using fine brushes for my artworks, especially when using ink and watercolors and when creating line art. So I was super excited to get not just one, but 12 different fine brushes. Each brush came in a plastic wrap to protect the brushes and the bristles, but unfortunately there were two brushes with slightly damaged bristles due to the plastic wrap. That was slightly disappointing, and I've already informed Fabrian about this issue as soon as they arrived, so hopefully this doesn't happen to anyone else who may be interested in purchasing these brushes now or in the future. The brushes themselves are pretty good, and they look well made. They are lightweight with a glossy finish, and the handle's design has that knob, which gives you a good grip when using it, especially since these are very small brushes. And as I've mentioned before, these are made with Japanese synthetic fibers, which are super soft, and they also retain their form even after multiple use. I'm very interested to see how long these brushes last me, as I use a lot of synthetic brushes, which have lasted me a while if taken good care of, so hopefully I get a lot of use out of these. My only concern with this product in general was the foldable case that came along with the brushes. Whilst it looks so beautiful and I'd love to keep the brushes in their original case, unfortunately, I will not be storing the brushes in the case. I realized that after leaving the brushes in the case and then storing that case in my drawer for months, I think the canvas may have creased, therefore damaging one of the brushes, which is pretty unfortunate because I now have a total of 3 damaged brushes. It sucks, but I can still use them, so it's also not really that big of a deal. I feel like I just learned a lesson, which is to now store the brushes with the rest of my other brushes, which are in a jar, hopefully keeping them and their bristles in pristine condition. As for the foldable case, I will be using it for other items, just not a brush. I feel like it's perfect for pens or pencils that I want to carry with me when traveling to work or to uni. And so that's my little review of the fine line miniature brushes from Zen Art Supplies. As for the demonstration, I chose to create a full ink drawing, making sure there were lots of fine details in the drawing to really make use of the brushes and the different tips. I wanted to draw something with lots of beads or gems, like jewelry, but I also wanted something relatively simple. And I know it may not look simple, but I'm basically just drawing a person's bust, which I do all the time. So it's not an extremely challenging subject to draw. However, the headpiece is the true showstopper. That's where I went bananas with the details, like the small beads, the details on the leaves, and the flowers. And to balance it out, I went with little to no details on the hair. And by complete accident, I ended up creating this gradient hair, which I absolutely love because overall the drawing looks well balanced with the heavy amount of black on top and the heavy amount of white on the bottom. There just needed to be some kind of transitional element in the middle, and I think that's the hair. So I'm really happy with how this drawing turned out. I also got to try the different brush tips when lining the sketch, and I have to say that the rigger brushes, the brushes with the long thin bristles, they were perfect for creating long, smooth, thin lines, but they were very tricky to control. I will have to get used to them to really master using them for line art, especially because my hands shake when creating fine details, and I'm very much used to using the round brush for line art. But with the round brush, they make my shaky hands very obvious. With the rigger brushes, I feel like it completely eliminates the shakiness of my hands. But it's just very tricky to control, especially when to stop the stroke. So I think that's something that I'll just have to practice with. For small objects like the beads, I used the 5/0 round brush, as that gave me the most precision. And of course, I also used the flat and the filbert brushes for the black square, which were larger areas that needed to be painted. And I used the size 2 round brush to paint the braids. I had so much fun using these brushes and creating this artwork, and I do recommend these brushes if you're also interested in line art and fine details. I will link this product and Zen Art Supplies website in the description box, so please check them out. All art materials used in this video are also listed down there. With that said, I will end today's video. I hope you like this video and the drawing I made with these brushes. Please give this video a like and subscribe. Share this video to fellow artists, and thank you so much for watching. I wish you the best of luck with your art journey, and I will see you in my next one.